You're watching Beyond Markets, where we bring you up to speed on development outcomes in Africa. Welcome, I'm Kenneth Igbomo, and thanks for joining me. On the show today, the Comptroller General of Nigeria's Immigration Service clears the air on Nigeria's new visa policy. And later on, SAP's Regional President for Southern Europe, the Middle East and Africa tells us how African companies and countries can take advantage of the link between Africa and Dubai. You can join the conversation on social media and let me know what you think about the topics we discuss. And to do so, use the hashtag Beyond Markets on Twitter and also send me a message on my handle, that's at Kenneth Igbomo. Now, the Comptroller General of Nigeria's Immigration Service, Muhammed Babandede, says Africa's future may include a common passport and no land borders. In an exclusive interview with CNBC Africa's Christy, he clears the air on the new visa policy and how it affects Africans.
Nigeria is an African country, and all African governments have agreed and signed African Free Trade Area. In it, there is a section for free movement of persons. The future of Africa may be that Africa may have a common passport. Africa may have no land borders. People could move freely among themselves. We are able to achieve this in West Africa under the Economic Community of West African State. We have a free visa area for all our citizens. That's why we call it equal citizens. So there could be a possibility of having a free area of movement for Africa. Mr. President demonstrated that leadership to allow Africans to pick their visa at the point of entry. It's not visa free. It is to pick the visa at the point of entry.
So talking about agreements and signings across between countries across Africa, Ethiopia and Nigeria have just signed a visa waiver agreement that is set to be specific to diplomatic and official passport holders. I'd like you to give us some details and clarification on that.
We have signed visa waiver agreement for diplomatic and official passport holders with many countries. We have signed with South Africa. We have signed with China. We have signed with Brazil. So we have signed with many countries. Ethiopia is one of the countries that Mr. President has signed. Which means, it doesn't mean that it is a visa free for others, but all those who hold diplomatic and official passport who want to do government work, there is a waiver. It means those category of people who are not going to pick visa, they will arrive at the port of entry, will stamp on their passport, seen on arrival. There will be no visa, and they will enter our territories, and we too will do the same.
So agreements and understandings seem to be prominent features in our conversations so far. Mm-hmm. When we think about these two specific items, if I could use that word to qualify agreements and understandings, what would you say failed or was missing between Nigeria and the United States such that Nigeria had to feature on the revised and updated restrictions for entry into United States?
First, it is important to know that Mr. President has set a committee to look into this, but it's important for people to know what is the restriction. The restriction is for residency. The visa restriction for the U.S. is for Nigerian to take up green card. That's simple, residency. And the U.S. complained of certain issues, which I don't want to talk more details because Mr. President has set a committee to look into it and find a solution to it. But the most important is that each country has a right to determine who it will enter, except set a condition. And our new visa policy is reciprocal, which means we should be able to reciprocate anything that happens between our partners wherever they are.
That recently Nigeria slashed visa fees for United States, for citizens of the United States of America, from $180 to $160. Is that true? And if it is true, what informs this decision?
It is true. We have to reconcile our visa fee with the U.S. They were charging $160, and we have agreed that we will change our visa fees to $160 each. All our charges have been reduced to $160 for American citizens, and that has been reflected, and we are expecting the Americans to do the same.
We're expecting the U.S. to reciprocate
yes.
the offer. Can I call it an offer now?
Not an offer. There was a fee for $160 with the U.S. Nigeria, and U.S. added additional fee. If you get the visa, you get additional fee. So we don't want that fee. So we have agreed to make it $160, and U.S. we expect them to make it also $160.
This is just the beginning of the year 2020. What can Nigerians look forward to?
We expect visa liberalisation, especially from African colleagues. Mr. President has taken the right step in the right direction by liberalizing visa for Africans. or holders of African passport, wherever they are in the world, that they can come and pick their visa at the point of entry. So we expect to see opportunity for the Nigerian passport. You know, I saw a ranking, people say, ranking for Nigerian passport, that it was very low.
It doesn't look like we're doing very well on that list.
But the ranking is not for the document. It is the ability of that passport to enter a territory without a visa. That's the meaning of the ranking. If Nigerian passport, when I hold Nigerian passport, how many countries can I enter without a visa?
But that's what the ranking is based on.
That's what we're saying. So that ranking will improve, obviously, because we have given offer to many countries in Africa that you can come and pick your visa at the point of entry. So the opportunity is there for many Nigerians to pick their bag and go to African countries. We expect to see reciprocity before the end of 2020.
So if I get you correctly now, Nigerians should look forward to having a stronger passport. I'm using the words of the populace now.
Yeah, but they should understand that stronger passport is not the document. It's ability to enter territories without a visa. So at least there is one already for diplomatic and official passport with Ethiopia. So if you have an official and standard passport, it has become stronger one step ahead that we can enter Ethiopia without a visa if one has diplomatic official passport. So that's the strength of the passport we are measuring.
So the liberalization is a first step for Nigeria now across Africa in view of the fact that all of this is based on reciprocity. Are there talks between Nigeria and other African countries to reciprocate in such a way that it's now easier to get into those countries? I know you say we expect it, but are there talks?
No, you see, these leaders agreed already. This was a decision by African head of state to liberalize that. It's a process. Mr. President just demonstrated leadership to show opportunity that you can, we want to start. So all the leaders are committed to African free trade area, which includes movement of goods and people around the area. So they're already committed. They need just to demonstrate it like Mr. President has started it. And this our visa policy, even Nigerian in diaspora, we should expect better. Because we are going to give opportunity under the new visa policy for Nigerians who have dual citizenship, who cannot have the right to practice that dual citizenship, to come to Nigeria even with their foreign passport. There are a lot of Nigerians living in countries where dual citizenship is not accepted. We are giving opportunity, we are developing the details with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs so that these Nigerians who are living in countries like Israel, like Germany, like India, like China, like Japan, this country doesn't accept dual citizenship, but they are Nigerian by birth. This visa policy has given them opportunity to pick their visa at the point of entry. So the opportunities are great for Nigerians, even in diaspora.
So just to be clear, sir, the liberalization policy of the Nigerian government on visa is very strongly tied to the actualization of the African Free Continental Trade Area.
It's only one of it. We have developed our visa system from 6 categories, classes, to 79 classes. One of the classes is classes for Nigerians by birth. The other one, classes for Africans. But all short visit visas have been divided into around 28, which can be picked at the point of entry. So I'm glad to say that the opportunities are there, even for investors who would like to come and invest. There will be opportunity to say, if you have certain amount of money, I can come to Nigeria and not pick only visa for entry, but also for residency. So the opportunities are there for all our technical and economic partners in the world.
To what extent would you say that the security features on Nigeria's visa provisions are better than what we had in the past?
So many ways. We have listened to the public, to the Nigerians. We have even consulted stakeholders, including our security agencies and law enforcement in the country before we roll out this visa, and ask them what are the fears. One of the biggest fears is that, terrorists will come directly to our country and fill this country. I said, no, this visa is more secured than the previous visa. The visa you will get at the point of entry is biometric. We'll capture your photograph, we'll take your fingerprint. This facility is not available in our embassies for now. We're not able to roll out. We're able only to roll some few visa, biometric visa in such countries. We have deployed a fingerprinting capturing system also at the airport when you enter. We have also introduced migrant registration after entry. If you are staying more than 90 days, you must register. So you can see the futures, the strategy in terms of security is even better than for you to pick a visa in your capital. It's better you come and pick it, you pick a biometric. So Nigerians should not be scared because there's a monitoring mechanism. Job lost, another cry. Oh, foreigners will come and take it. No. This visa on arrival is only for short visit. Any African who is coming to take up employment, that African will go and get the right visa at the embassy. So it's only for short visit, not to take residency in Nigeria. That's why we have the different categories of visa. Other fears Nigerians have, foreigners are coming to take the visa free. It's not free. They will pay at the point of entry, but they will pay electronically. Somebody even say, immigration said they will collect cash. We have never said that. You will pay electronically, online, or with your card at the point of entry. So those fears have been addressed.